Hello Techies, in our previous tutorial we have learned how to retrieve and send emails from Gmail using email automation. To access Gmail messages we need to enable less secure apps in our Google account. But from May 30, 2022, Google is no longer supporting the use of third-party apps or devices to sign in into our Google account using our username and password. So that if this feature is not enabled, we cannot retrieve or process our emails using email automation. Alright, where we will find this less secure app access? Go to your Google account or Gmail account. On the right hand side, you will find your Google account. Click on that. And there you will find manage your account. Click on manage your Google account. Once you click on the manage your Google account, it will redirect to myaccount.google.com. Under that, you will find security. Click on that security tab. And after that, if you drill down over here, there you can see less secure app access. To protect your account, apps and devices that use less secure sign-in in technology that are blocked. Over here, previously, we are going to be enable or disabling this account to use our Gmails over there. But here, this feature is no longer is available, so that you will find it out. This setting is no longer available. Now, we got our real problem. Now, how can we go ahead and retrieve our emails from the Gmail? There is an alternate option we have to read emails by using Gmail API. What are the key features of Gmail API? The Gmail API is a RESTful API that can be used to access Gmail mailboxes and send email. By using Gmail API, we can read and send messages. We can manage drafts and attachments. And also, we can set up push notifications and manage settings. Gmail API allows you to make API calls using standard web languages like Java, Python, .NET, Curl, and many more on its dashboard. Gmail API uses the OAuth 2.0 protocol with robust authentication features for data security. Gmail API can create email filters to find and manage email messages. And finally, Gmail API is available for free, but it has certain daily usage limits for API calls. All right, where we will find this Gmail API? Go to browser and provide the URL that is console.cloud.google.com and click on enter. For the first time, it will ask Google account username and password. You can provide Google account username or password or Gmail account passwords. Right? In that case, what it will do, it will redirect to the page that is welcome. Now, if you observe over here, I'm having on the left hand side, I'm having Google Cloud. If you click on that one, there you will find API and services. For the Gmail API, I need to enable from my libraries. Where I will find that? Over there under the API and services, there we are having library. Click on that. There if you see, it will say welcome to API library. The API library had the document links on smart search experience. There you will find a lot of APIs related to the Google, such as Maps, Machine Learning, and Google Workspace also you will find it. And also you have YouTube also. Now, if you observe over here under the Google Workspace, there we are having Gmail API. All right. Now, by using this Gmail API, we can read our emails, we can send our messages, we can draft the messages, and then also we can go ahead and we can send the push notifications. There you can see, to work with the Gmail API, first of all, this API has to be enabled. So how can we go ahead and do that? By clicking on enable option. From here onwards, we'll learn how to configure Gmail API.